Hey, what's going on YouTube? My name is James and welcome back to another video. So today I'm going to be covering a subject that a subscriber sent in. I think it was a really, really good question. It was actually asked in the comments with what I thought he would expect to be a reply. But instead I was like, that's such a good question, I might just make a video on it. So we're going to jump into that in a second. Before we do, yes, I've had a haircut. The man bun is gone. I now have it slick back. So yeah, those of you who hate the man bun, you can now be happy. Those of you who love the man bun, I'm sorry. It will rest in peace, don't worry. And today I am wearing the Auris. So the question comes in from Peter Lorimer? I'm sorry if I butchered your name, but Peter, that's what we refer to him as. He's always in the comment section of most of the watch videos, so thank you very much for being a part of the community. And if any of you guys have any other questions that you'd like to see me answer, feel free to either leave them down in the comments or email me. That's the best way to do it. But today I'm just going to jump straight into this and I'm just going to read his entire comment and then we're going to go over the points he asked. So he said, "Hi James, hope you're feeling better now. Just a little question for you to hear your view. Have you seen the new Ocean One Vintage Chronograph by Steinhart, the homage to the iconic but stupidly expensive Rolex Paul Newman Daytona? At least €980, a little over £850. Would you give any thought to buying one? Indeed, as you've owned an Alpha Sub in the past, what are your views on homage watches in general? Let's face it, the Paul Newman Daytona is a gorgeous watch, but it's a piece that's that precious few of us would could ever hope to buy the original Rolex made version of. Are you of the opinion that you wouldn't be seen dead wearing such an overpriced fake abomination, or do you take a more liberal approach to the subject? Just thought I'd throw the question out there. Take care, bye for now." Well, first off, Peter, thank you for the question. It's a brilliant question. The way I'm going to cover this, because I've never openly spoke about my opinion on homages, you know, I've done a review of the Alpha Submariner, which is literally a homage to the Rolex Submariner, and this is a really interesting subject because I don't really know what my standpoint is. Now, before you click off the video going, "Well, what's he going to say?" I have multiple different opinions and I understand everyone's opinions on both sides. You know, you've got the people who are completely against homages. You know, they think they're the most stupid thing ever. It's literally ripping off. It's like homages and replicas are the same thing in their opinion. Like, and then you've got the people who are just completely for homages. They're like, "Well, at the end of the day, I can't afford that piece, so why should I not be able to experience something that looks like it?" You know, and I think I've spoke about my opinion a few times. I'm sorry, I'm a bit bunged up, but I've never fully put it in a video saying this is my opinion. So let's jump into it. What we're going to do first off is take a look at the Ocean Vintage One Chronograph by Steinhart. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to put up a few pictures from Google just up on the screen so you guys can sort of see what I'm looking at. I literally just searched Ocean Vintage One Chronograph into Google Images and I'm just looking at a few pictures. So, okay, so what do I think of the way it looks? Well, I think it looks beautiful. I really do think it looks beautiful. Obviously, it is a homage to the Paul Newman, as Peter was saying, and I really do like the way it looks. This is a very, very good looking piece. Now, if I'm correct, it's not a, like a direct homage. There's a few differences. So let's have a look. Okay, so I've loaded up both pictures and I'm looking at them now. Yeah, there's not much difference at all, actually, apart from the one I've opened up. I think this is correct. Paul Newman has the red lines around the outside, whereas this doesn't. Yeah, pretty much they're very, very similar, that's for sure. But at the end of the day, that's the point, isn't it? That is the point of homage, to pay homage. It has a 30 minute totalizer on the left side, whereas the original has a 60 minute totalizer, or is that the seconds? I think that's the seconds. No, that's the main seconds, but the main seconds on the Steinhart is on the right. So they've been swapped round. The totalizers have been swapped round with the seconds. Other than that, yeah, they are the same. Now, what do I think of it? I think it looks awesome. And what is my opinion on homages? Let's just jump into that. When it comes to something like this, like a Rolex Paul Newman, which are in very limited numbers now and very, very, very hard to find, even if you've got the money, because I've heard people like on forums who claim they have the money to buy one, but just can't find it anywhere. So when it comes to a homage like that, like this piece, in my opinion, is paying homage. It's not ripping off the Paul Newman, it's paying homage to a piece that many people can't or probably won't be able to ever own, even if they have the money. That is paying homage. Now, when it comes to pieces like that, I'm for pieces like that. Would I ever own something like this? If I had the money, I'd probably still say no, because to me, at that kind of price range, I could get an Auris or a Hamilton or something along them lines, or a few Seikos. To me, that's more appealing. But I could understand why someone would want to own this. And I think it's beautiful. And if any of you guys out there own any Steinharts and are willing to send it me so I can review it, please email me down below. I'd love to get my hands on one, because everyone's talking about them, but I've never experienced them. I don't really want to buy one because it's a lot of money that I don't have right now to spend on a watch like that, especially. So anyway, back to the point. I think something like this that is paying homage to a piece that's almost impossible to ever own is an okay thing to do. That's my opinion. I think it's okay. But that being said, homages of like stuff that could be very attainable, like I say very attainable very lightly, because to me it's not attainable, but to other people it's attainable. The Rolex Submariner, right now in my current position in life, is nowhere near attainable ever. But could that change? Of course it could. Do I think homages of pieces like that are okay? No, I don't. And the reason being, when it's a piece that could be very attainable, I just don't agree with them being homages. But then there are exceptions. For example, the Bulova Moonwatch, the quartz version, is not homage, like people say, to the Omega Speedmaster. It's not homage to that, because it's got its own history, which dates back to the moon landing. You know, and people claim that to be a homage of the Speedmaster. It isn't. It has its own separate history. It's just at that time frame, they were making watches that look kind of similar. That's kind of what a lot of people were doing back then. At the end of the day, there's pieces that are homage watches to the Paul Newman that were bought out around the same time that look identical. Are they homages? Yeah, I guess, but not in that same sense, if you get what I'm saying. They kind of have their own history. You know, Theo and Harris had one that was this sort of same style as the Paul Newman. And in my opinion, it wasn't bad wearing it. Whereas if you bought, let's say, the Steinhart, which is literally looks identical to the Submariner, I probably wouldn't agree so much, you know, with people owning it. But at the end of the day, we've got to remember, people can own whatever they want. At the end of the day, there's only so many designs out there that can be done. And people always say the same thing. I think I even said it. If only they just made original design, it would sell. The truth is, it wouldn't sell. It wouldn't sell at all. One of the biggest markets in watches is the fake market. It's the replica market. It's huge. It is literally massive. And I think discouraging homages so much as people do promotes fakes. And you might be like, how does that even make sense? Well, the people who want homage watches are usually the people who can't afford the real thing. Hence, Alpha Submariners being so common and popular. They are, they really are. People buy them because they don't think they can attain the real thing, or maybe just don't want to pay that price for the real thing. They just don't want to, you know. Or in the example of me, I wanted to see if I even liked the design of the Submariner. I had never even tried on a Submariner. Most places I went into wouldn't let me try it on. Because, you know, I was an 18-year-old kid at the time. They were just like, no, literally. Some places were like, no, we don't show that, I'm afraid. They do, they just didn't want to show me. So I couldn't even tell whether I actually liked the design of it on my wrist. So I bought the cheapest thing I could that was automatic and had a similar feel. Obviously, it's not the real thing. But I bought that so I could see if that design of a Submariner I'd like. And you know what? I didn't really like it that much, to be totally honest. Are they two different things? Yes. Design-wise, no, in my opinion. If I bought the Steinhart Ocean Vintage 1 and I tried it on and I was like, this looks disgusting on me, then I wouldn't ever buy a Paul Newman. You know, not like I ever could, but you get what I'm saying. That's why I think homages are good. And this community that, and there's a lot of people out there, I'm sure one of you watching are one of these people who literally slam down people who buy homage watches. You know, they're like, this is ridiculous. Why should you own that? You know, the whole reason it's as expensive as it is because only few people are ever going to own it. Why should you ruin what they own by owning something that looks similar but costs you barely anything? And that's usually their argument. And to that I say, I get where you're coming from. If I paid £8,000, let's say, for a Submariner and someone went and bought, I don't know, an Alpha Submariner for like £100, would I be annoyed? Probably a little bit, because I paid £8,000 and they got something that looks similar, obviously is not similar, but looks similar for like £100. But you've got to remember, you discouraging homages that much probably promotes fakes more, because at least then people will think, oh, that's a real Submariner at a quick glance. You know, the fakes are getting really good nowadays and people seem to be forgetting that. That's why I respect Navsan so much, because he reviews fake watches in detail. Like, he literally looks over them. He did it for one of the Cartiers. Was it the tank? I can't remember. It was one of the Cartiers, and literally, it was ridiculous how good it looked. The box, the papers, everything. It looks so legit. And they're about the same price as Homages nowadays because of the quality of them. Now, do I think we should promote either? No, I think we should promote original design, and I really do stick by that. You know, at the end of the day, this is original design from Auris. It's really original. It's just beautiful. But people will want something that they can't have. It's just the way it is. I want a AP Royal Oak. You know, I really want an AP Royal Oak at some point in my life. Would I buy a homage to it? No, but that's just because I that's the kind of person I am. I want that challenge of getting it. I don't want something to fill that void until then, you know what I mean? But for some people, they don't ever want to do that. Some people never want to pay that much for a watch in the first place. So they want something that looks similar. I think for them sort of people, we should be promoting homages rather than fakes. Even though we're not promoting, you get what I'm saying. You discouraging homages so much usually pushes people towards fakes rather than pushing them to original design because they want something that looks like that. That's why they're buying that homage. So personally, I am of the opinion of if you want to buy homages, buy homages, buy what makes you happy. Don't let people tell you otherwise. That's my opinion. But I would rather people bought original design. But at the end of the day, it's up to them. So I'm not going to be that person sitting there going, buy original design, how dare you, it's a shitter. And all stuff like that. I'm not going to be that person. But do try and buy original design. See what else is out there for the same price. For the same price of this this Steinhart, you could probably buy a secondhand Auris, you know, or a Hamilton. Would I think you'd be better off with them? Probably, yeah. I'd probably say you would be. But it's up to you at the end of the day. And my opinion on the Steinhart Ocean 1, I think it looks beautiful. But then again, so does the Rolex Daytona, Paul Newman. And that's obviously what it's paying homage to. So if it didn't look beautiful, I'd be a bit worried considering it's paying homage to it. Anyway, that's my opinion on this. Hopefully it made sense. It's difficult talking about this, especially after my Vostok video, which I got a lot of hate for because I voiced my opinion. So I've got to be careful voicing my opinion in the future, but I can't not voice my opinion, I'm sorry. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like, and please do create a discussion down below. This isn't an argument. This isn't me saying what you think is wrong. If you think homages are the worst thing ever, I'm just trying to make you open your eyes to other opinions, you know, and that's why I think YouTube is so great. You can have one video, one person saying one thing, another video where one person is saying a complete other thing, and then in between you've got this conversation building, which I think is really, really important for all opinions on everything, ranging from watches, games, politics, anything. That is important that you have two completely different sides, because then it creates a discussion which creates like logical thinking. So let's have that discussion down below, not arguments. Don't call me out for being stupid or anything. That's not the way to discuss things. You know, if you have a different opinion, let me know down below. Explain your opinion. Don't just say, homages are shit. Like, give a bit more than that. Come on. Anyway, thank you for watching. I'll see you all in the next video. Thank you for watching. Peace out. Take care. Bye-bye.